Okay, we've got a no cool call on the second floor. I do not believe we have been to this house before. And the customer did not give any real symptom. So we don't know whether it's actually blowing or not, or freezing up, or not coming on at all, or what's going on. A lot of times we can ask a couple of questions and get a little bit of a hint to what's going on, but we don't have anything this time. So let's go out here and see what we can figure out and try to get the people some AC. It is finally warm weather. And she's one of those that stopped you at the door and stepped outside, so not so sure if we can fix the air without getting in. I'm assuming if I had to get in, she'd let me. And she's working to put hot air out, and that one's not on. She was going to go cut it on right now. So let's give this a minute. Looks like somebody's been in it. Screws are loose. That one's finger loose. It's like a funny shaped, funny looking terrier that I don't really recognize. I don't see them that often. Huron, so it's definitely a carrier lately. It's safe to say this one, let's open it up and look at it. Okay, pushed it in with my finger. It is putting hot air out of the top quickly. So, for whatever reason, it is either not being told to turn on, or it's not turning on when it's being told. So, let's see if we can figure this out right quick. We may have water in the pan upstairs, or who knows, but it just appears at the moment here. To not be getting low voltage call to bring it on. Can't imagine it being any different here at the wires, but all right, so let's go inside. She'll let us and look at the thermostat, drain pan, wiring, etc. Something has definitely got us not calling. Alright, she did not have it on. All she had on was fan. And of course, argued with me that. Anyway, sometimes people get confused and they flip it to on, just the fan. I mean, I don't know what she had done, but anyway, let's get some gauges because it is turned on and running now, so might be a different issue. All right. Being a 410 unit, we're going to run it a minute and watch what these things do and go check the filter. Kind of temperature putting out. They may have never even turned it on, actually. Wish I'd had the video on when I walked up, but the dogs were making all kind of racket, and I think that's why she had blocked us from getting in. But let's go back in. Okay, so I did get up in the attic. just thought, you know, I better see what's going on here. And we do indeed have a drain pan about half full of water, so I don't know if it drained out or what it did, but we're gonna check the primary and get some of that water out and hang around and wait on it to make water. This thing's not real super powerful, but sometimes it will. While we're out here, I'm going to go ahead and unhook our gauges. That doesn't look perfect to me, but you know, we're here to do what we're hired to do. Fix the problem. I already asked about servicing and general maintenance and if they wanted us to service the other one, and absolutely not. Just fix the problem that's stopping it from cooling, get it back cooling, and that's all they want to do today. Probably watching the money, so I'm going to go ahead and unhook this and we'll go back to the attic. Okay, here's the two matching carriers. There's one with a little bit of water in it. Now, it does have a pipe off the back and, oh Lord, off the side. Look at that. It is going uphill big time. There's no way for that to drain. It does have a float switch in it. So, let's get some water out of it and see what we can do. Alright, so I'm not sure if somebody came in and moved these refrigerant lines around or what, but we got it back under. So that was up over the refrigerant line there. Still not sure, but that it's gonna drain, but at least it does have a float switch, so I'm happy about that. Looks like the seal is okay. Yeah, it feels good. I think we're okay. We got most of it out. So I just want it fixed. I think we're gonna leave it just like this. Alright. Everything should be okay here now. I did talk to them and showed them the little small clip of that dirt stuff coming out of the drain line over there, and they are both dripping now, so I think they'll be okay. Well, that was quite clogged and pretty nasty, but of course you're always glad when you see something like that. Then you know you're getting somewhere, you know. And so fortunately today We have one more call and we are headed in. So I'm pretty happy about that. And another fortunate thing is, thanks to the good Lord and some good luck and a little bit of planning, the next call is about 1 mile from this one, and I'm probably not more than 4 or 5 miles from the house. So all right, I think that's 4 down today and 1 to go. So we'll see what happens at the next one. Thanks for watching.